Dr. Suhas, yes.
Over to you, ma'am.
Dr. Suhas, I had already done the introduction, so I want Dr. Suhas to start his presentation.
Thank you so much, Chitra, and sorry for the inconvenience. I know Dr. Partho, my good friend, must be waiting with Bofors guns to demolish what I'm going to say. But then, well, LRI do have a role for for refractive accuracy in low grades of astigmatism. See, LRI is a time-tested and scientifically proven technique. And with better understanding of its functioning, it is more reliable and more accurate today than in the days when it was introduced. Small cylinders have suddenly become eyesores to cataract surgeons, especially when you're doing customized cataract surgery. But not all cylinders can be tackled with toric lenses alone. And that's where the LRI still comes and it can be used as a standalone procedure or as an add-on or touch-up procedure if it can be positioned in that role in our practice beforehand. See, what I talk today focuses on low astigmatism management. It's either one or less than one during or after cataract surgery, be it with the rule or against the rule. If you look at this slide, these are patients who present for cataract surgery in the age group of 50 to 60. And it's amazing to see almost 36.5% of them with cylinder of 0.5 to 1. Now, this is a large segment which I can easily target with my LRI if the patient cannot afford a toric lens. And the second group in the previous slide are those patients with larger cylinder who, after having toric lenses put in them, sometimes do have some residual cylinder. It could be sometimes 0.5, 0.75. Now, these are another group of patients whom I target with LRI. Next. Now, factors that influencing effects on LRI, either it's a corneal thickness, patient's age, corneal diameter. So finally, the depth and arc length of arcuate incision will be calculated as per the nomograms. Just to refresh, when a deeper cuts will definitely give you more flattening and more set. Next slide, please. More central the cuts, more will be the flattening. Now let's look at this case. Now, I have used Varion that is not recorded here. You do not see Mendy's marker here, but I'm going as per the Varion. It's always better that you do your LRI beforehand. You measure the peripheral corneal thickness. You use a variable diamond knife. And if the nomogram tells you to keep your cuts away from your main incision, you can accordingly do it. And at the end of the surgery, you can just flush your groove that is created for LRI. And then, you tend to get very... Next, please. Next. So, where do LRIs fit in my practice today? During pre-op workup, if the patient has a cylinder which is more than one, obviously he goes in for... next. Goes in for a toric lens, or if you can't afford toric, he'll go for an LRI. If the cylinder is one or less than one, and if it's with the rule, I would probably do nothing or do LRI. And if it's against the rule or oblique cylinder, the obvious choice is either LRI or a toric lens. Next. But the question comes when you have a cornea with an irregular astigmatism, when you have a corneal scar, when you have asymmetric bow tie, when you have keratoconus, or when you have cases where toric has absolutely little role to play, and these are the cases where LRI has everything to offer, if not in totality, but to a large extent. Next. And this can be easily done by using different nomograms. We have LRI calculator nomograms, in which the popular ones are NAPA nomogram and DONO. Both of them you give good results, my personal preference is for Napa Nomogram because it takes into consideration the peripheral corneal thickness and accordingly your diamond knife is set. Next. This is a LRI calculator in which you input your K1 and K2 and thinnest corneal depth in the periphery, and the machine, the program will tell you where the incision should be, what should be the size of your arcuate cut, and what should be the depth of your diamond knife that you're going to use, and what will be the residual astigmatism. Next. So my final thoughts is that it's a simple procedure. Next. If done methodically in small cylinders, it works as good as a toric lens. And the regression is insignificant when you're dealing with a small cylinder. Can be combined with toric lenses or used as touch-up procedures in the post-op period in eyes with a residual cylinder. Can be combined with multifocal IOL packages in low cylinders where cost is already an issue. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Suhas. That was a-